push forward, and notice that there's a spring up with the back leg. The weight's still in the back leg. Once I feel that I've not been successful, then roll back down to a
position,
and the B person sinks back down to the back leg. A push, and a return. That's all that B is doing. Notice that the B person is just springing up on the back leg and back down again. Up on the back leg and back down again. The A person starts in a Peng position. When the B person pushes, notice how the palm rotates outward. Now the palm is facing forward. Why does the palm have to turn? If you don't turn, because it's difficult to get the rotation the rotation of the hand helps to rotate the force away. Notice how the back goes back. The hand goes towards the center of the partner's chest. In this practice, your hand is actually
in
touch, but it's just there. If you wanted to, you could use it. If you didn't want to, you don't have to. So the hand is right there. Notice the wings on the back leg. There's a bend backward from the waist. And then roll back down to an up position. And when one person is up, the other person is down. And then one person up, the other person down. Seesawing back and forth. The eyes look forward at the partner. Both partners are looking either at the eyes, or shoulder, or chest. Be sure that the hand goes above the eyes. The left hand naturally moves forward or thrusts the palm apart, but doesn't actually make that move. If the person pushes again, then the other partner will be in a big disadvantage. Let's say that push, deflect. The hand hasn't touched but is there waiting. The partner sees, oh, it looks like I have another opportunity, but notice he runs right into my waiting hand. And so that's why it would be to your disadvantage, even though the hand is here in waiting position. This is the relaxed. This hand is relaxed in the back. This hand goes
on.
Suppose I don't relax this hand. Then I push myself away. But as soon as I can relax this hand, there's nothing to push anymore. So this is how you begin to learn how to drop the partner into the void. How to get their energy to be grounded and voided into nothingness. And it all comes with staying relaxed. So keep the arm relaxed. If your partner insists on continuing to push, then you just relax even more and thrust the palm to the hard hand. Find your partner.
Yes.
One.
Er.
Two.
三
，three。 more the bow is drawn, the greater the energy that can be released. So if you don't build up the spring in the back, you're not opening the bow, the possibilities. So pay attention to the back. Try to, without, try to, as best you can, gather as much energy in the bow as possible. This is a backward bow.
See what the partner's going to do next.
become stuck.
最要紧的前腿要,
the most important thing is to keep this front foot free and lively.
这个我已经有距离了,
unless you have a little bit of distance between your partner.
我再一退步,
but, for example, the partner may be getting close, but all you have to do is take a step back and you create more space between them, if you need space.
所以是要中心做前腿。So,
whatever
you do,
keep the weight on the back leg, body relaxed.
再念对方,
try to immediately have your qi become one with the partner's qi.
身体比较好,
and don't be afraid.
也有害怕心理性,
the more you have a fear, the more you cannot relax.
那就是怕输,
and you're afraid of losing. And the more you're afraid of losing, this idea of losing and winning, and the next you know, you are losing.
你没有怕的心,
but if you don't have a fear of losing,
不用一弄输了,
there is, you don't have this comparison of winning and losing, then you can only win.
就是大家记住啊,
so give yourself totally to your partner. Don't create separations like this with fear. It's not meaningful and it's not
helpful.
These are things from Taijiquan
sense.
If you can understand truly the idea of giving yourself totally to your partner, your gongfu will improve by leaps and bounds.